Now, Albert Bandura took Skinner's idea of environmental influences on people's behaviour, but he thought that cognition was still important in terms of behaviour and how we express personality. Cognition is thinking. Bandura thought thinking was an important cause of personality that had been overlooked. Remember, the behaviourist said, you can't ask questions about thinking because you can't measure thinking. Now, for Bandura, the most important part of cognition that determines personality is expectancies. He argued that personality is the interaction between a person's traits, their thoughts, and the environment that their behaviour is expressed in. It's through the process of reciprocal determinism that these things affect each other. Reciprocal determinism refers to the idea that behavioural, cognitive, and environmental variables interact to produce personality. To give you an example, imagine your expectancies here are that you want to do well in a course. Your expectancies might influence the environment that you find yourself in. So you might end up going to the library more often around the time an assignment is due. In the library environment, you see other people studying, demonstrating studying behaviour. So you engage in more study behaviour. You start to realise that, hey, because you're doing all this study, you've got a good chance of doing well. So your expectancies increase. You think you're going to do well, actually. As you think you're going to do well, you'll engage in more study-related behaviour because you realise it could be effective to do that. You find that generally your study-related behaviour is facilitated if you go to the library, so you tend to go to the library to study because that's the easiest place to perform the behaviour. These things all influence each other to produce what's expressed as personality. Now, this is a pretty interesting approach because it brings cognition back to a central role in personality through expectancies. One of the criticisms of Bandura's social learning approach, though, is that it relies on, as a central part of its explanation, these expectancies. You need to have the cognitive machinery to be able to form these expectancies, which is a higher level of cognitive function. But we still see social learning in animals that don't have that cognitive machinery. So maybe expectancies aren't so important for personality after all.